Lord has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will arouse them. That little guy on the left in the white shirt is my grandpa Frank. That's Jack in the middle, and their sister Mary on the right. After this photo was taken, two more kids were born to Simon and Julia Bartosic, Gertrude in 1895 and Hattie in 1898. When we were children, Gramps used to tell us stories about growing up in northern Wisconsin, stories with trains and wolves and meteorites in them. And they had happy endings. But when Frankie was 16 years old, all the children fell ill. And whatever it was, Big Brother was sure that it was he who had brought it home. The boys recovered, but the girls did not. Hattie died on December 12, 1904, Gertrude on the 15th, and Mary on the 25th. They were 6, 9, and 14 years old, respectively. When he was an old man, Frank still wept like a little boy when he told that. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue so that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. The people who welcomed Jesus to Jerusalem by waving palm branches in the air over him and laying their cloaks in the street under his feet on that day long ago were tired of suffering. Through centuries of corrupt leaders, war, famine, pestilence, and exile, the Jewish people stubbornly preached a God who still loved them in a fatherly way. They expected that of God. And they were expecting of Jesus a word that would rouse them and free them from their suffering. That was 1 week before he was put to death. Brothers and sisters, what do you expect of the Lord today on Passion Sunday? To make it through this latest human crisis? For what liberation do you seek? A long life? Good health? Better relationships? Financial security? The fulfillment of worldly plans? All of those things are in our power to accomplish. For example, over the last weeks, we have been told again and again that our future is literally in our own hands. There's so much that we can do to protect ourselves and others in this time of pandemic. It takes courage. It takes patience. But we can do this ourselves. The Lord Jesus offers us what no man can do for himself. He offers us himself, sacrificed on the cross for the forgiveness of sins. He suffered willingly for others. He was condemned to save sinners. That means us. The gospel of Jesus Christ only becomes compelling when we humbly accept that. Them is us. God doesn't need suffering. We do. We do. Suffering is our responsibility. And if we own the passion, it is ours. The suffering is ours. The fact that Jesus takes it upon himself, the sinless Son of God, takes it upon himself and frees us from the guilt of it, the gospel of Jesus Christ becomes something to live for when we do that. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue. Of course, it is Jesus who speaks those words, but also his disciples. The disciples intimately united with their brother Jesus in the church, which is his body. A well-trained tongue that he might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. It's the beginning of Holy Week. Today is the gateway to all those stories of how God's only Son took the misery of the world upon himself. Those stories are the preface to a world of other stories of how the disciples of Jesus were changed after they saw him risen from the dead. True stories about men and women like us, whose cowardice and selfishness were turned inside out into heroic courage and self-sacrificing love in the light of the sacrifice God made to prove his love for them. If you want those stories to move you, there's only one thing necessary. You can't blame someone else for what's wrong with the world. You can't go around the cross. You need to pick it up. You need to make it yours, as he did. You take it up, and you carry it home. I can't climb into that beautiful photo and warn my family about what was going to happen to them. But I can wait in hope of drinking the new wine of Jesus in the kingdom, and with Grandpa Frank and Uncle Jack, and with Hattie and Gertrude and Mary and their parents. That is the word that rouses us. Jesus has already destroyed death. Passion is doomed. We can all wait in hope to be gathered together to our own people. In the meantime, there are brothers and sisters down here who are suffering right now, suffering from corrupt leadership, from war, from hunger, from sickness, from exile, from the death of loved ones. The disciples of Jesus noticed that. The disciples of Jesus always notice that suffering and react.